compile this application, we can see the frames in real time. You can see me right there, and it means that, guys, I got the frames. I got. Hi, DreamCode is here back again, and today we are going to discuss about how to use and how to record your frames from camera, from that camera which you are seeing me, yeah, or any other camera. So in order to do that in a virtual machine, as I am doing here, you need to install the extension patch, which you might found on the internet. And also, I have required to upgrade my VirtualBox, so I'm going to upgrade it right now. So I'll hit agree here, yes, and I'll try to upgrade it. And also, we have the extension patch. Cancel. Okay. And if you're going into preference, into extensions, we can see that we have the VirtualBox extension patch. With this extension patch, you can use your USBs, I think you can use even your camera and stuff like that. So I'm going to start the Ubuntu, because I'm working on Ubuntu, and I'm going to show you how you can easily Ubuntu, how you can easily create a Python application. So in order to see if you have a camera connected, we can go in, we can list something, ls-lh in dev video, and you can see that we actually have two camera connected. One, I think, is the integrated camera, which is actually selected right here on the device. So we head back to our application here, and I start to develop an application which will read frames, so from the camera. And also I do something here. Okay, now it's working. And here I'm going to write something like frame equals camera point read, and we are going to read each frame. Then we are going to display our frame, so cv2 dev image show. This is only for showing the current frame, and we can write here like frame, like camera, and then we're going to get the frame, right? So we're going to give the frame, and after displaying the frame, we have to break, like, this is what you must do. It's something which allows you to break from this while through and exit the application. So I'm doing a condition here, if cv2 dev wait key is 1, and right here I'm going to do stuff like this. This is only a condition to check if we press a key, and when I'm pressing the Q key, we are going to break from this while true to respect the Python format convention. Then after we are doing the while through, we are going to release the camera release, then we are going to destroy all windows, we are going to destroy our image show. This image show will display frame front window. which will display the frames in this while through. I can also do here a delay. I can also create a separate thread which will read the frames. I can do a lot of stuff, but I'm simply starting the application, getting the source which I'll add here, then I'll read frames. Clear. Let's try again. I forget to I'm going to show you another command is kill pkill minus 9, which is killing the Python tree. In case you can't close it, you must do this because the application might broke or something. Now let's try to compile again and we still have the error. Yeah, I found a problem. The problem was because here on the my application which I'm recording, the integrated camera was activated and it was already used. That's why I got this problem here with assertion error and not resource temporary unavailable. We have this warning. So right now, if we are going to compile this application, we can see the frames in real time. You can see me right there. And it means that, guys, I got the frames. I got the frames from my camera. I don't know if, but it might be possible to change the width and the size of this frame because it's not that, you know, okay. Let's see. Yeah, and as you can see, the frame is awesome. The resolution is max. It's like the HD resolution. You can see me pretty clearly, but you can see the lag because I haven't give like a lot of resources. So if I'm going here into HTOP, we're gonna see that we don't have information. So in the next episode, I'm going to show you how you can use HTOP because it's a simple tool which you must use if you're using the Linux. HTOP will allow you to see the how resources are, and we are going to see how many resources does this application will take. So I'm going to push this code. Let me see. I'm going to clear everything to see what I'm writing right here. I'm going to save this a little bit. Git. I'm going to add this. I'm going to add this red camera. Then I'm going to status again to see what's happening. So we have a new file, then git commit. I'm going to commit because I'm going to say here added the read camera script. It's actually Python script. Then I'm going to git push origin master. Actually, after pushing, you must pull. It won't do anything, but I'm doing that. Yep, everything is okay. So if I'm status, everything is okay. If I'm going into the git, you'll see that I have this code push, so you can see it. Let me see if everything is okay here on our repo. So as you can see in our repo, we have now the read camera, so you can watch the code if you want to get the code. So I'm going to explain you fast what I did here. It's just a simple function which is reading from video source. Then I could even do these steps inside, so I could even do something like this. It was like, I don't know, and let's see, width, height, we could do something like this, and we could send this as parameters. It was the same thing here, and we could specify here the width and the height. It was the same thing. And after calling this, we simply read frames and we display frames. Then we wait for a key to be pressed, and I choose the Q key. So after pressing the Q key, the camera will release and the window will destroy. I'm going to compile again to show you that it worked. I'm heading back to disable the camera so we can run this script without any problems. And voila, everything is working fine. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button. I'm going to press key right now. Pressing key. And stay tuned for another episode with Dream Code, where I'm going to evolve this application. Maybe I'm going to read frames from a source, from a video source. You can do a lot of stuff, guys, with this. You can create your own application which is recording, or I don't know, which is doing amazing stuff with CV2. So we only imported CV2 and we have everything. So yeah, stay tuned for another video. Don't forget to hit that bloody like button and subscribe to Dream Code, because next week we are coming back here with another episode. Have a nice day, guys.